Duffy's Tavern, where the late mate Dade Archie demands you speak, and Duffy's out of town. Oh, hello, Duffy. Duffy! When did you get back? Well, yeah, but I thought you were still up in Canada with that bad case of hay fever and Mrs. Duffy. Well, tell me, how is the fat and buxom Mrs. Duffy? She got fatter, huh? Well, that's matrimony, Duffy. You marry an armful and you wind up with a roomful. You what? You're sending Miss Duffy down to look at the books. Why? Now, look, Duffy, just because you are a crook, don't think that every... Now, Duffy, no intent offended. Now, Duffy, you know your hay fever. Don't get excited. Gesundheit. Now, Duffy, stop flying into a transom. Duffy, I'll call you back.
George, so Miss Duffy is coming down to look at the books, eh?
And what have I got to worry about?
What have you got to worry about?
Yeah.
Mr. Archie, while Duffy was in Canada, did you hire 14 of your friends to work here as waiters?
Yeah.
And did you pay them with Duffy's money?
Yeah.
And is Miss Duffy coming down here to look at the books?
Yeah.
That's what you got to worry about.
Eddie, you and your witty sism. Look, these guys, before the war started, these guys worked in a record factory. They was me pals. They ate here regular, right?
Right.
Right.
And Arch ain't the kind of a guy that lets down his pals, Eddie.
Right. So I think it is me own for negative if I wish to take care of a few of me friends until the factory reopens up again.
If the factory reopens up again.
If the factory. Look, who owns the National Phonograph Record Company? P.J. O'Malley. And who is the father of the girl that I intend to make me future intended spouse? P.J. O'Malley.
So?
Eddie, don't be such a septic. P.J. himself says to me, he says, Archie...
That's you, huh?
Yeah, he says, certainly it's me. He says, Archie, our troubles may be over today. It all depends on a certain little enterprise, see?
Enterprise.
Yeah, enterprise.
Enterprise, black, gold, and sunbonnet.
Stay there,
at the three quarters, it's enterprise by a link.
Enterprise,
black, gold,
come on, you
sunbonnet.
Enterprise, come on.
Into the stretch, it's enterprise, he's black, gold, and sunbonnet. With Cloverdale coming up on the outside. At the finish, it's Cloverdale violin, black gold second, and sunbonnet is third.
It's official. The time, 1:36 and 3/5. The winner, Cloverdale, paid 1860.
May I use your outside phone a minute, please?
I'll connect you. Park Villa. Would you like to? I'm 7, Peggy. It's your father. Well, thanks. Hello, Pop. Where are you? Did you see the banker?
Yes, I'm in his office now.
What'd he say?
Oh, everything's going to be all right. All the money I need, just as soon as I find the shellac. I'll tell you all about it at dinner.
Oh, well, Pop. Where'll we eat? Oh, not again. All right, meet you at the tavern.
When she sees who my own private friends are and how they send me their own private autographs, wonder how I ought to sign this one,
How about the groaner?
Yeah, not so much familiarity and just enough contempt.
The only contempt you got to worry about is in court the day after Miss Duffy sees them books.
Eddie, leave us not burn our bridges until we come to them. Besides, I got bigger things on my mind tonight.
Such as?
Get a load of that. What do you say, Finnegan?
Thanks, Arch. I'm too young to get married.
Not you, Finnegan. Miss Peggy O'Malley happens to be me Prince Charming, and tonight is the night.
Hey, Arch.
What?
That tie is kind of loud, ain't it?
Quiet's down when I wear the shirt that matches it, sir. Eddie, where's the bay rum?
We use it all up in the Cuba Libre.
Oh. Well, I guess it don't make no difference how you smell when you got what I got. Magnetism, fellas. Personal magnetism.
Hi, Arch.
Hey, fellas, look who's here. It's Danny Mike.
Hey, Danny. Hey, Danny. Hey, Danny. How are you? How are you?
How are you?
Yeah, permanent. They tell me I can't fly anymore.
Oh, you're okay narrow, huh?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Oh,
all right.
Swell, kid.
Hey, look, tell me, what is this, gig?
Come on, the back room. I'll give you the lowdown. Come on, fellas, it's time for dinner anyway.
I can stand on the street. I'm
good to see you, Daddy.
Daddy Murphy's back.
Hey, if you don't mind, I'd like a bowl of soup.
Okay, I'll be with you right after dinner.
O'Malley could open the factory if he really wanted to.
You can't blame O'Malley, Danny. You know you can't make records without shellac.
And the Army's got it all.
Who says so?
O'Malley.
But he's expecting some.
Any day now.
Any day, my eye. You know, O'Malley, you can sit here for a lifetime.
So it takes a little time to find the shellac. So what? Rome wasn't burnt in a day. In the meantime, I want you to stay right where you are. The policy of Duffy's Tavern is that Duffy takes care of his pals.
That's pretty swell of Duffy.
Certainly. Of course, you don't know about it yet.
Miss Archer, they're here.
Who?
That certain socialite and your future spouse.
Oh, pardon me, fellas. I got a little business.
Wait a minute. Let's get this straight.
I'll be right out, Eddie. Peggy, please.
Night after night, sponging this food from Archie. Doesn't it do anything to you?
Gives me a little heartburn sometimes. Besides, dear, I told you I'd pay him back.
We could pay him now if we didn't put every cent I make into keeping up that house. And if you didn't have to have steak and champagne every night.
I've got to keep up a front. I mean, Archie doesn't mind extending a little credit. Especially where you're concerned.
That's another thing.
Well, good evening. May I welcome you once again to these humble archives?
Good evening, Archie, my boy.
Hello, Archie.
Won't you sit down?
Thank you. For my lady. And may I say that you're looking pretty as a picture tonight?
Pretty as a picture. Ah, oh, what a lovely thought. Archie, you could turn the head of Cleopatra herself.
Who?
Cleopatra.
New York girl?
What a sense of humor.
Yeah. Oh, I bet you were a killer in your history class.
History? Well, I was only in the class valedictory.
Oh.
According to my old prof. That's a nickname for professor.
Oh, I didn't know.
Yeah, yeah, that's what we always used to call him when I was at Harvard.
Harvard?
Yeah.
Archie, are you a Harvard man?
Heavens, yes. As a matter of fact, my grandfather was one of the founders of Harvard.
No.
Mm. Brilliant professor, my grandfather. Could read and write like a whiz. What's the matter, P.J.? You look incredible. Don't I seem to reflect of it?
Oh, certainly, certainly. Everything you are today is a reflection on Harvard.
Oh, gee, thanks. I used to love it up there. Good old Eli. And I was quite a student, too, you know. Took almost every subject. Biology, trigonometry, physics, arithmetic, algebra, calcium, gym. So, you see, Miss O'Malley, you ain't brushing elbows with no bum. Me old pal Bing Crosby. Oh, he's trying to get me to come out to Hollywood to get engaged to one of them seminar stars. You know, but, I guess a guy can do all right here in little old New York, eh, P.J.? Look, Miss O'Malley, there's something that I've been trying to tell you all.
Some other time, Archie.
Okay, shall we say tonight about 9?
Oh, I'm sorry, Archie.
Yes,
I'm afraid
I'll... All right, Archie, 9 o'clock will be fine.
Good. As I say, there's something that I'm trying to tell you that...
And there's something I've been trying to tell you, too, Archie.
Yeah, huh? Well, that's swell. I'll see you later.
See you later.
You see, Eddie? Magnetism. Personal magnetism.
You better save some of that magnetism for when Miss Duffy gets you to look at the book.
Well, if it ain't Miss Duffy.
Hello, Finnegan.
Just a minute. Is this man following you?
If he was, you think I'd be walking this fast?
Oh, I'm sorry. I apologize. I almost made a mistake.
So did I.
Did you have a good time on your vacation, Miss Duffy?
Oh, yes, Finnegan. The part I enjoyed, I liked. The part I didn't enjoy, I didn't like. That is as much as the part I liked.
What part did you like?
The travel.
Travel.
Oh, yes. Travel is wonderful, Finnegan. It's really the only way to go anywhere.
Yeah, I'm going to try it the next time I take a trip.
Hello, Eddie.
Miss Duffy.
And where, may I ask, is our so-called manager?
Miss Archer, I think he's in conference back there.
Please inform him of my presence.
Yes.
But, Danny, do you have to see O'Malley tonight?
Why not?
Well, I got certain personal reasons, and leave me assure you that if these personal reasons work out,
Mr. Archie.
Don't bother me now, Eddie. If these personal reasons work out, then O'Malley will get the shellac. Now, don't go upsetting everything tonight.
Mr. Archie, she's here.
Who's here?
Miss Duffy.
Just asleep. Miss Duffy. He good. Gad, man. Fellas, I'll be with you in a second. Eddie, give the boys a cup of coffee, huh?
Well, what do we do now?
Hello, Miss Duffy. Gee, I'm glad to see you. You're a sight to give a person sore eyes. How have you been?
Archie, what's the matter? You're shaking like a leaf.
Just a habit from punching the cash register so much.
Business certainly ain't giving you no palsy tonight.
Oh, well, it's a little empty now, but that's on account of the opera crowd ain't arrived yet.
Archie, I'm not blind, and Papa sent me down here to look at the books.
Look, Miss Duffy, did you have a good time in Canada? How is things? How is the manpower situation up there?
Men? What's men? I didn't see hide and a hair of them.
All baldies, huh?
Oh, very funny. Now, if you don't mind, Archie, the book.
What else did you see when you was up there? Did you see the quintuplets?
Oh, yes. You should have seen them. Sitting there staring at my pop staring at them.
Who paid who?
Hey, Arch, how's for a cup of coffee?
Sorry, Fagenspan, we're all out of coffee.
Archie. What's going on in there?
I forgot to tell you, Miss Duffy, we got a new room back there, the Louis the 14th room.
And who, may I ask, shares the occupancy of said room?
14 guys.
All named Louis?
Well, no, a couple of them we just call Lou. They're soldiers. They used to work at the record factory, and they've been away since the outbreak of the duration.
14 soldiers?
Yeah.
All men?
Yeah.
Very interesting.
Yeah, very.
But, Archie, the factory's closed. Aren't these men out of work?
Well, only partially. They're waiting.
And eating?
More or less.
Archie, does Papa know about all this?
Well, Miss Duffy, after all, a bunch of guys go out and fight a war.
Archie, does Papa know about this?
No, and he don't have to unless a certain near relative of his happens to shoot off a big mouth.
Archie, I'm going to tell
Papa. Go ahead and tell him. I ain't ashamed. Any decent American citizen would do the same thing if he had an ounce of red blood in his corpuscles.
About it, Arch. He'll get paid back every cent.
Archie, I don't believe he's had the pleasure.
I ain't worried, Danny.
I don't believe he's had the pleasure.
Hey, where are you guys going?
Get a little fresh air. We'll see you later.
Oh.
I don't believe I've had the pleasure.
Oh, Sergeant Murphy, may I present you with Miss Duff, the daughter of the establishment?
Hello?
Likewise, I'm sure. Do you intend to locate permanent in the neighborhood, Sergeant?
Well, it's possible.
Might I say the Army's loss is our gain?
That's possible, too. See you around.
Too bad you have to tell your old man. Means we'll have to get rid of them guys.
Archie, did you say there were 14 of them?
Yeah.
Oh, 14 to 1.
Not bad odds, huh?
Archie, those men have just got to be fed. It's a patriotic duty.
Oh, but Miss Duffy, what about the books?
What a person don't know, don't hurt him.
And I think I know the home to who you refer.
Good night, Archie.
Good night, Miss Duffy. Magnetism. Boy, I'm loaded with it.
Come on, Pop. What did they say at the bank?
Oh, I got it right here in my pocket. Came this morning. Look, I'll show it to you. All the credit. The name of O'Malley Command.
Why, that's wonderful. It won't be long now. Frankly, I didn't think you were going to get the money, but what's that you always say? A man has enough enterprise. What's the matter?
Well, look who's here. The boys from the plant. And, oh dear, it's Murphy.
Who?
Plain, unadulterated trouble.
Well, boys, what a pleasant surprise.
Hiya, Murphy.
Hello, Chuck.
Hi, Shorty.
Yeah, I'm glad to see you. Peggy, go put on some tea and cake.
Don't bother. It's not a social call. We're here on business.
Oh. Well, is there anything in particular, boys?
Just one little question.
Just one little question?
When does the plant open?
I'm glad you asked that question, boy. If you don't ask questions, you never learn anything. as President Millard Fillmore once...
O'Malley, are you looking for shellac?
Looking? Me? With a Bing Crosby master just lying there crying?
Where have you looked?
Well, I went down to the place over by the... and they sent me back down to the... and they told me that... Well, it'll be any day now.
You guys want to stake your future on this double talk, okay. I know what I'm doing.
Don't worry, Pa. Murphy, wait a minute. Mind if I walk along?
Sidewalk's public.
You're quite a fighter, aren't you? Hot-headed, too.
Name's Murphy.
Mine's O'Malley.
How's that make us, besides Irish?
What's your first name?
Danny.
I like the way you talk, Danny.
So?
Nothing. Just thought you made a lot of sense.
Thanks. I'll go to the head of the class.
Oh, look, I know how you feel, but why take it out on my father?
Who's responsible?
Well, maybe he hasn't looked hard enough for the shellac, but he's an old man. Sometimes he lets things slide.
This time he slid right out of business.
Well, that's not true. I just saw a letter he got from the bank. He can have all the credit he wants. If only someone would go out and find the shellac. Believe me, if I were a man, I...
Wonder what it's like inside.
Let's take a look.
My company still has confidence in your old man. This is like coming back to your girl and finding out she's not your girl.
Pretty sad, isn't it?
Yeah. You should have seen this place when it was really humming. Mac and Chuck over there at the Stampers, Lou and Joe in there making the biscuits.
Biscuits?
Yeah. That's where they press the records from. It's made out of clay and guess what?
Oh, don't tell me. Shellac.
Right. The cause of all our trouble. Has to come all the way from India.
Danny, there must be some boats getting through.
Yeah, possibly. Over there is where the whole thing starts in the studios. They make the master recording on wax. These are the presses. We're going full blast. These babies can turn out 500 or 600 records an hour. Come on over here. I'll show you the playback room.
Hello,
Finnegan. How do you like it?
Gosh, they are perfectly stunning.
Thank you.
They're a new shirt?
Last week.
And going out with a guy, okay?
What else? You know what they say, Finnegan, in the spring, a young man's thoughts turn to something a little fancy.
Peggy O'Malley?
Yep, Peggy O'Malley. First girl I ever really wanted to marry.
So, yeah? So what about Emma Pfeffer, Katrinka Yarbarch, Tashi Mumler?
Playthings. This one is different. She's so lovely, so fragile. Kind of a girl you really want to place on a pedestrian.
Hey, Arch, how are you going to get O'Malley's consent?
Oh, diplomacy, Finnegan. And a diplomat always carries his diploma.
But, Arch, you don't drink.
But O'Malley does, touche.
So, good luck to you, Arch.
Have a cigarette, PJ.
Oh, thanks.
Ned. That's a very fine drink. What am I drinking, Archie?
Brandy, it's quicker.
Huh?
I mean it. Better with soda. Try it with soda. Brandy and soda.
Oh, yeah. Brandy and soda. Yeah, yeah, that's much better. That really makes the drink.
Yeah.
What were we talking about, Archie?
We was talking about the plans for me marriage.
Well, marriage. Oh, well... That's a wonderful thing, Maris. Yes. Now, you take me. I was married for 25 years. No, don't take me.
Well, PJ, leave us review the status of the quo. Do I marry the girl or don't I?
Well, did you get her father's consent?
This is what I am trying to do.
What did he say?
What did he say?
I don't care what he said. You're too good for it.
The man is a dipsomaniac. Look, PJ, think clear now. Think clear. Archie, Peggy, wedding bells, yes or no?
Do you know what I think?
What?
I need another little drink.
PJ, I'm asking you for the last time now. Do I marry your daughter or don't I? Now, yes or no?
If I had another little nip, I think I'd say yes to anything.
You would?
Yeah.
Ooh. And you'll never regret it, Dad.
Just what we need. A little drink to celebrate.
I never touch this stuff, but you can drink for the both of us, I'm sure.
You drink with me or I don't drink. And if I don't drink, the whole thing is off.
Well, you leave me with no alternate.
Atta boy. Here's to you and me. Two of the nicest guys that I ever met.
To us.
To us.
Can't figure myself out. First night I'm back, moon in my eyes, girl in my arms, much on my mind. Shellac.
What are you going to do about it?
You sure you saw that letter from the bank?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Tomorrow I'll get those guys out of the tavern. If there's any shellac around, we'll find it.
Oh, Danny, that's wonderful. Let's go tell Pop.
Yeah, let's. Right away. New Guinea was never like this.
Neither was New York.
You know something?
What?
Murphy was never like this either.
Neither was O'Malley.
Why shouldn't you marry Peggy if you want it?
That's what I say. Why shouldn't I?
Still, on the other hand, when you come to think of it, why should you?
Certainly. Why should I?
Certainly.
Certainly. On the other hand...
Certainly.
I'm glad we see eye to eye.
When I think of my little Peggy married...
PJ, I don't want you to feel like you're losing a daughter. I want you to feel you're gaining a son.
Somehow I started to feel I was losing the joy.
I'll drink to that.
Get some leather and some beer in the icebox. Let's go look. No beer.
Yeah, you're extravagant.
Extravagant?
Forgot to turn a little light off.
Oh, don't be silly. Close the door, light goes off.
How do you know?
I saw it once in a movie. Look, I'll show you. You open the door, light goes on. Close the door, light goes off.
How do you know?
Look, when do you have to look at the stuff? When the door's open. When don't you? When the door's closed. So close the door, light goes off.
How do you know?
You're the dumbest son-in-law I ever had. Now look, speak for yourself.
Well, didn't say it go off.
Better let me try.
Didn't see it. How are we gonna find him? Let's sneak up on him. I'll find out. What are you gonna do?
I'm I'm going to settle this thing once and for all. I've always wondered about this thing, and now I'm going to make sure. Okay. Now, you close the door and count up to three and then open them.
Okay. One, two, three. The light go off?
I couldn't see. My glasses got all steamed up.
Here, let me try it.
Now, you didn't give me a chance.
Yeah. Now, close the door, count one, two, three, and then open it quick.
All right. One, two.
Pardon me.
Excuse me. I think you're leaning against the doorbell.
I guess I'd better be going.
No, no. Don't hurry off. Take your time. Go right ahead. Don't mind me.
What, Archie? What was you telling me in them Roman numerals?
Come on, you gotta go home. Get out of here, quick.
Good night, Danny.
We'll get back in here. Oh, but I'm frostbitten already.
I'll defrost you.
Oh, Pop?
Yeah?
Brace yourself for some wonderful news.
News?
The boys are going out tomorrow to look for shellac. I know they'll find it.
Yeah, so do I. I mean, will they? Do you think so?
Of course. Isn't it wonderful?
Oh, that's wonderful. Ants, I'll have to spread some powder. Now, you run upstairs. You've got a hard day tomorrow.
Good night, Pop. Oh, what about Archie? Did you take care of him?
Now, don't worry. He's on ice.
Come on, Archie, get out of there. You all right?
O'Malley, if I die from pneumonia tonight, you're gonna hear from me in the morning.
Now sober up, Archie, sober up. We're in trouble, terrible trouble.
What's the matter?
Now, don't ask questions. Just go on home and pray that it doesn't happen.
Pray that what don't happen?
I got a letter from the bank, and they won't give me any more feathers. So just pray that the boys don't find the shellac.
Pray they don't find the shellac?
Yeah.
Certainly.
See you at the wedding, Dave.
Yeah, good night,
Archie. Good night. Be careful of the back steps, sir.
Don't fall. He must be drunk. Hello, Duffy's Tavern, where the elite meet to eat. Oh, hello, Duffy. Duffy, I got some news for you. Huh? You what? You got a bill from the butcher this morning for $600. The money, Duffy, we spent quite a bit of money fixing up the place while you was away. We redesecrated it. Well, Duffy, you ought to see it. Now the kind of a place that a guy don't have to be ashamed to bring his own wife. Well, you're different. You can be ashamed to bring your wife any place. Now, Duffy, don't get excited. Gesundheit. Duffy, will you stop? Gesundheit. Not... Well, you can't do that. Duffy, you can't do it. Well, it ain't ethical. Now, look, Duffy. Hello? Holy cat.
What's the matter now?
He's sending down a guy to look over the books, a CPA.
Huh?
One of them satisfied public accountants. Eddie, what are we going to do?
Your intended father-in-law better find that shellacking today.
Yeah, he better. Holy cat. Now, what was it I was supposed to pray shouldn't happen today? Oh, thanks.
Park Villa. Betty Hutton? I'm sorry, Miss Hutton can't be disturbed.
Ray Milland, I think you'll find him in Mr. Crosby's room.
Yeah, they're all here. Some kind of a bomb show.
Oh, Danny, you found it? Oh, that's wonderful. Gosh, Dad'll be so happy. Meet you at the tavern right away. Watch my board for me, will you, Grace?
Good morning, Archie.
Oh, hello, PJ. How are you feeling this morning?
Not so good. I guess it was the soda.
Hit me, too.
Oh, did Murphy and the boys find the shellac?
How should I know? By the way, why was it you told me last night I was to pray shouldn't happen today?
Well, don't you remember?
Good news, O'Malley. All the shellac you can use. Look at that.
Europa. You know what this means, PJ? It means that the boys go back to work. I pay back Duffy, and all you got to do is get down to the bank and...
What's the matter?
I just remembered what it was I was supposed to pray shouldn't happen today.
What are you talking about? You knew this all the time? And the shellac was just an excuse.
Oh, believe me, Murphy, I tried every which way to raise that money. I even...
Never mind.
Daddy.
Here. Don't lose it. It's your mail ticket.
Now, look what you've done. A CPA coming down to look at the books, and I'm $1,200 short. $1,200 of Duffy's money.
Duffy's money? What's money to Duffy?
What's money to Duffy?
He can't take it with him.
There is one guy, if he can't take it with him, I guarantee you he don't go. You don't know that Duffy, that dirty, double-crossing, cheap, chiseling, no good. I was only kidding, Duffy. Now look, E.J., you got me out of this. Now, you got to get me into it. Now,
calm down, Archie. Remember, it's always darkest just before dawn.
Darkest before dawn. Here I am on my way to jail, and he's giving me perverts.
Wait a minute, Archie. There may be a way out.
What do you mean?
Duffy would not send his son-in-law to jail.
You ever seen that dame in the morning?
But this is morning.
That's what I mean. Besides, what about taking me betrothed?
Archie, would you want to go through life only seeing your wife on visiting days?
Yeah, I guess you're right. But when you tell Peggy, you take it to a kind of gentleman.
She may never get over this. But I'll try.
Thanks. Well, here goes. Miss Duffy, could I see you in private for a second?
Why, certainly, Archie.
Over in the booth. Eddie, two beers. Make mine a double.
Good luck, Archie.
Thanks. Miss Duffy, do you find me completely repulsive?
No, only moderately.
Good, then there's hope.
For what?
For Cupid's bow to tie our hearts together, Miss Duffy.
Marriage, Archie? You and me?
Why not? After all, woman needs man and man must have his mate. That no one can deny.
Isn't this awful sudden, Archie?
No, I've been thinking about it the last 10 minutes.
What?
I love you, Miss Duffy.
Oh, I'm sorry, Archie. You're barking up the wrong girl.
But you gotta marry me.
What do you mean I gotta?
Well, you just gotta, that's all.
Archie, how come you're so this way about me when I heard you were so that way about a certain other party?
Well, I'm changing horses in midstream.
Sorry, Archie. You'll have to find yourself another horse.
You won't have me?
No.
You sure?
Positive.
Looks like 20 years. On the other hand, it might have been for life.
Well?
She made me the happiest man in the world.
I'll change you down, huh?
Now what are we gonna do?
Don't worry, I'll think of something. I got one here that looks pretty good.
I hope you're satisfied. It wasn't bad enough to make a fool out of me with that letter, but to let them sit around and think they were going back to work when all the time you knew they
could. I know. There isn't a thing I wouldn't do to make it up to them. Believe me, if I could open the plant tomorrow, I'd give them all an interest in it. And a worthwhile interest, too.
You mean that, PJ?
I certainly do.
Oh, that's wonderful. Means the guys own a factory, they go back to work.
Archie, we still have to pay for the shellac.
Oh, yeah. Pretty lucrative amount, too, ain't it?
Yeah, over 3,000.
Where are we gonna raise that kind of dough?
So how about we run a shower?
A shower? Hey, but that gives me an idea. What about a raffle?
$3,000 with a raffle?
So how about bingo?
No, that's not good. Wait a minute. I got it. A block party.
Block party?
Like the Stamfitters and Welders had last year up on 18th Street.
Yeah, but they had a big show, Rudy Valley.
So what? We'll have a big show, too. Peggy, what about all the movie stars down at your hotel?
I don't know them personally. I only work at the switchboard.
Well, who can we get that knows them?
That's what we need, personal contact.
But Casey, Arch knows Bing Crosby.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We can only tell our story to some of them stars. I bet you there ain't one of them that'll turn us down.
Yeah, if we could only get up there.
Yeah. Hey. EJ, suppose you wanted to get into a place and you couldn't run door. What would you do?
Try the back door.
After you.
Here's the elevator here.
What floor did he say again?
36.
Hey.
Right.
Where do you think you're going?
36th floor.
You can't get off the 36th floor.
All right, we'll go to the 35th and walk up.
No, let's go to the 37th and walk down. It's easier.
Hey, wait a minute, wait a minute. You work here?
No, I'm going up to see a guy social.
Well, this is the service elevator. You'll have to go through the lobby.
Yeah, but...
Now, don't argue with me. Move along.
Just a second, bud. We're American citizens.
Well, so am I.
Got no answer to that. Okay.
Let's grab a quick lunch.
Okay.
Me Regan on the 36th floor.
What? The service elevator. She's not in. Painter's uniforms. Hey, a couple of crooks just sneaked up to the 36th floor.
Rembrandt. Don't look like my work.
Never mind.
It's white paint. Bill Demarest.
Come on, we got you. What were you doing in there? Come on, talk.
Why, Mr. Demarest, what happened?
Somebody ought to tell those dames, they're in the wrong place.
Hey, you!
Hey, come on, boys, get it back.
Come in here, quick.
Well, how do you do?
How do you do?
Pleased to meet you.
Oh, I'm pleased to meet you, too.
what a hunk of punker toad, huh?
Don't you know who that is?
Who?
Paula Goddard. Let's get her for the benefit.
Okay. What are you doing tomorrow night?
Come on.
Say, what do you think this is, an induction center?
I beg your pardon.
Well, it's quite all right. Come back at 4. We're serving tea.
Yes, ma'am.
That way.
Thanks.
Rushy, look down there.
I can't. I suffer from hyperphobia.
Yeah, but I'd rather be a mule. Well, let's try this room here.
Hope nobody's taking a bath in here.
Tonight we blow up Grand Central Station.
Eric!
Shut up, you fool.
They're watching. You shouldn't have come.
Plans have changed. We gotta act fast.
When?
Midnight.
The post office?
Later.
Spies!
But Eric, are we ready?
The bombs are placed, the wires are set. One little touch of that button and...
Eric, we can't.
Oh, it'll be beautiful. A blinding flash, a crash. And then... except for the screams and moans of those stupid people.
The rats? We've got to go in there and stop them.
Yeah, let me know how you make them.
But, Eric, there'll be troops there with their wives and children. Innocent people.
They'll die like dogs.
No. No, I won't let you.
I'm turning soft, huh? Well, I counted on that.
What do you mean?
You see that trunk? I didn't send it up here for nothing. When it leaves tonight, you'll be in it.
You wouldn't dare.
It's easy once you've done it. First the arms. Then the legs. Come here, Valerie.
We gotta save her.
Eric, put down that knife. Eric!
Okay, Eric, we got you. Okay, ladies, get safe. Call the cops.
You're darn right, I'll call the cops. Hello? Hello, this is Veronica Lake.
Veronica Lake?
Send the police. There are a couple of hoodlums up here attacking Alan Ladd.
Alan Ladd?
How you doing? Pleased to meet you.
May we assist you?
Yeah.
Now, please, Mr. Ladd, don't get sore. It's just a little mistake.
Mistake?
Yeah, well, we're here about a benefit.
When I get through with you guys, you're going to need a benefit.
Look out, Archie's a killer.
Out of my way, PJ. Every man for himself.
Spread out.
Betty Hutton.
I'll be with you in a minute.
Oh, I'm sorry, I can't. I'm having a massage. Veronica Lake recommended a masseur. Mm-hmm. I'll call you later. Are you the masseur?
Huh?
Masseur?
Masseur, huh? Oh, oui, madame. Parlez-vous français?
Oh, donnez-moi tout je sais. Da? Oui?
Madame's French. She is very bad. Leave us talk English.
Yes, leave us. Well, we're wasting time. Shall we get started?
Oh. Don't you think we better have a little music first?
Well, not necessarily. The alcohol's in the closet.
What'll you have for a chaser?
What'll I have for a chaser?
Oh, dear.
Now, who's he?
It's my assistant, Pierre.
You're his assistant?
Yeah, I assist him on every job he does.
Hey, now, wait a minute. Veronica didn't say anything about French masseurs. Where are you from?
Paris. Right, Pierre?
Right. We're a couple of parasites, right?
Right.
You don't sound like you were ever in Paris.
Madame, I have been in Paris oftener than April.
Yeah? Do you know the Rue de la Paix?
Do I?
Montmartre?
Do I?
The Champs-Élysées?
Do I know them? Three of the sweetest guys that ever lived.
Yeah, it's funny. I could have sworn those were streets.
No.
Well, you gonna give me a massage?
Massage?
Take your coat off, Pierre. On the table here.
Shall we give her the epilage?
No, we'll give her the appendectomy.
Hey, you both gonna do it?
Oui.
Hey, what am I, a project?
Please, madame.
Ouch! Oh!
Well,
hey, what are you guys, a couple of commandos?
Liz, madame should relax.
Yeah, relax.
By the way, Pierre, this is Miss Betty Hutton.
Betty Hutton? Well, how do you do?
Ouch! Hey, I asked for a massage, not an amputation.
Let's turn her over.
No, she ain't done on this side yet.
Oh.
Hey, save a leg for me. Now, who's that?
Oh, that's his assistant.
I'm the masseur Miss Lake sent me.
Masseur? Then who are you?
Me? I'm leaving.
Hey, wait a minute!
Grab him.
Hold it here.
Officers, I want to prefer charges against these men.
Look, we just come down here about a benefit.
You guys will get a benefit, all right? About 40 years.
I ain't gonna live that long.
Well, wait a minute, you don't understand. Oh, Miss Hutton, you've got to help us. It's about a benefit to put returning soldiers back to work.
Come on, sister.
Just a minute, officer. Now, what is this all about?
Well, you see, Miss Hutton.
Well, the dressing room just... Hey, you're Cass Daly, ain't you?
That's right.
Miss Daly, I want you to know I seen your latest picture 4 times.
Oh, it wasn't that good.
I know, but I kept forgetting where I come in. Gee, thanks. Thanks very much. You talk awful funny, don't you? Oh, excuse me, I gotta take this to Archie.
We have a story, Miss
Goddard.
Not
right now.
How about
a picture?
After the show.
Fine.
Hello, Miss Goddard.
Hello.
You look different from the last time we met.
Oh?
Something new has been added.
Eddie Duffy's only fluffing. He never sent down a CPA. What's with you? Your mind runs along one track.
And the first stop is Sing Sing.
Yeah.
Hey, what a good fit. Where'd you get it, Finnegan?
From my Uncle Morty, the Undertaker.
The Undertaker? Is it all right?
All right. He just took it off the guy last night.
Oh, well, that's all right.
Archie, yeah. Come on, the show's starting. You gotta get out and introduce the act.
Oh, okay.
Now, don't be nervous.
You don't want a CPA, Duffy. You want the district attorney. Yes, a clear case of embezzlement. There's $1,200 missing.
What's that?
You weren't even jailed tonight. All right. I'll call the police since we're out of warrant right now.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you don't mind me calling you that. We got a big show here tonight, a show that I guarantee if it was up on Broadway, it'd walk off with the Pulitzer Prize. Anyways, the first act takes place in the office of one of them Park Avenue psychoanalysts and features that lovely singing star and female chanteuse, Miss Betty Hutton.
Now, really, Miss Hutton, I'm only a psychoanalyst. If you want my help, you've got to cooperate.
Doctor, I'll do anything, anything.
Just lie down on the couch and make yourself comfortable. Now, perhaps you've been working too hard. About these hallucinations, what form do they take?
Murder, he says. Murder, he says. Quick, went the curtain. Wham went the window. Punch went the new buffet.
Is there anything wrong?
No, nothing unusual.
Suppose you just relax, Miss Hutton, and tell me how it all started.
At the early age of 3, it
occurred to me. A girl should always try to improve herself. While the others played with toys, I practiced charm and poise and finished Dr. Elliot's 5-foot shelf. I exercised each morning, cold cream my face each night, saw my dentist twice a year, curbed my appetite. And so I modestly admit, it didn't help one single bit. Some girls can make any man dream by flashing an innocent gleam. Me, I do a nip up, curl my upper lip up, light a Roman candle and scream. I have to do it the hard way. Some girls can wear any old rags and capture the wolves and the stags. Me, I dress in sables, walk across the tables, waving free American flags. I have to do it the hard way. Let's say there's a dance, they're playing a waltz, and I want romance. That's when I begin turning somersaults. Some girls can keep men on their toes by smiling and throwing a rose. Me, I rack my noodle, whistle Yankee Doodle, balancing a broom on my nose. Oh, I'm a-telling you, part, I have to do it the hard way. My freshman year in college, I remember I was mild. I wore pretty clothes, got an A in geometry, a normal child. But nobody wanted to date me. I'd sit at home and dream. So in order to get attention, I had to scream. The fellas liked girls who wore perfume, so I bought forbidden flower. But I had to mix it with ether to get them in my power. I didn't want to go crazy, but I ain't kidding, Jack. Since that time, I'm telling you, I'm raving, whining, impetuous, panning, violent maniac. The girls who read books and wear specs get fellows with great intellects. Me, I get fanatics, guys who live in attics. Yes, I even pick up the checks. I have to do it the hard way. Suppose there's a park, a boy on a bench. I'm out for a lark, so I make him fall with the monkey wrench. When someone like Hedy Lamarr steps into the swankiest bar, all the fellas get up, light her cigarette up. Me, I'd have to smoke a cigar, and then they call me a cunt. Doing everything the hard way.
And when he finished with the book, he found you were $1,200 short. And you know Papa's temper. He's going to throw you in jail tonight.
Tonight?
If you'd only wait, we could raise the money. We'll be making records tomorrow.
Why not tonight?
Yeah,
why not? PJ, is Richardson still your distributor?
Yes.
Where's the phone?
Right here in the office.
I'm interested in records, Murphy, not promises. Deliver those Crosby platters, you'll get the money.
Mr. Richardson, we've got to have the $1,200 tonight. All right, how many copies will you take as a guarantee?
1,500.
1,500? But we can't... Okay, it's a deal. Be at the factory in 3 hours and bring your checkbook.
Wait a minute, Danny. 1,500 records? In a factory that's been closed for 2 years?
Danny, can you do it?
What do you think, Riley?
Well, what are we waiting for?
Okay, tell Mac and Burns to get down to the warehouse and pick up that shellac. Then gather up the rest of the boys and tell them to go down to the factory.
Okay.
Johnny, you stay here and do your act. Come on, Peggy, you can be of some help, too.
Hey, wait a minute. What about the cops?
The cops? Stall them. Keep the show going as long as you can.
Yeah, go ahead. I'll keep my eye peeled for the gendarmes. And watch out for the cops, too. And now, folks, on account of I'm the master of ceremonies here, I think that it is no more befitting than proper that I should tell you the joke. So, on my way to the theater tonight, a panhandler comes up to me and he says, say, Bud, you got $2.05 for a cup of coffee? So I says to him, coffee is only a nickel. What's the other $2 for? So he says, sleeping tablets. Coffee keeps me awake. Well, so much for humor. The next act is a blackout and features Paulette Goddard, Brian Donlevy, and Sonny Tufts. And laugh them up. They're three nice kids trying to make a living, huh?
Has he gone?
Yes.
Darling.
Darling. Oh, alone at last.
Isn't it wonderful?
Oh, it's the Colonel.
What do we do now?
Quick, get the closet. Darling. You're back so soon.
I had to come back. I had to. Last night I had a dream, a terrible dream.
Darling, what was it?
Oh, it was too horrible, too terrible. You were here with another man.
I? How could you even think such a thing?
I didn't think it. I dreamt it. It was so vivid. I can see it all now. You were alone in this room. Suddenly, through that door came a man in uniform, a second lieutenant. You flew into each other's arms. Then there was a knock on the door, and you said, it must be the Colonel. And he said, what'll I do now? And what do you think you said?
Quick, get in the closet. No, no.
Well, he got in the closet. Then you let me in. You kissed me, but I knew there was something wrong.
Wrong?
Right. So what did I do? My blood was boiling. I walked to the closet. I grabbed the knob, yanked it open. But I couldn't look.
Of course you couldn't. It was just a dream. It was a nasty old dream.
Well, dream or no dream, I tell you, I saw the guy. A second lieutenant, mind you, with my girl. My blood was still boiling. Again, I walked to the closet. I grabbed the knob. I yanked it open. But I couldn't look.
Oh, of course you couldn't. Because it was in your mind. It was all in your mind.
Yeah. That's what I tried to tell myself, but it didn't work. I knew there was a man in uniform in that closet. My blood was still boiling.
So no, Brian, no! Oh!
I walked to the door. I grabbed the knob. I yanked it open.
Who are you?
Captain Sonny Tufts, sir. No, the guy was a second lieutenant. Forgive me, darling.
Darling.
They didn't show up yet, did they?
Who?
That CPA guy and the cops.
No, maybe they're going to wait till... Uh-oh. Now, you keep out of sight. I'll take care of that. Ah, hello, O'Brien. What are you doing here?
Sorry to bust things up, but he's got a warrant. I've got to take Archie.
Oh, Archie? Well, you can't...
Orders is orders, O'Malley.
Well, all right. He's in his dressing room. Come with me.
Comes to you direct from Duffy's Tavern, where, by the way, you might drop in after the show for a slight smack. And don't let them dirty windows deter you from going in. It's really a very high-class joint. We patronize only the best people. Countesses, duchesses, princesses, dukes, barons. Heavens, it's a novelty when a pheasant walks in. So, as I say, the next act comes from Duffy's Tavern and features one of our waiters, Johnny Coy, and his girlfriend, Miriam Franklin, in a tap ballet entitled Johnny Comes Marching Home. I'll be back with you again in the night.
Way down. How many have we got?
About 1,200.
That's not enough.
Pardon me for butting in on these acts like this, but somebody's got to introduce them. And confidentially, you know, I'm beginning to like this stage stuff now that my nostrils have tasted the smell of the greaseball. Anyways, our next stars is Eddie Bracken, Walter Abel, Charlie Quigley, and Alga San Juan in a sketch that takes place in a Hollywood movie studio. Well, I think you've taken enough of my time.
Ready to shoot, Mr. Sturgeon.
Get the rest of the people on the set.
Yes, sir.
We go, Ronnie?
Yeah, let's do it.
Now, this is the scene. Black and his mob have Gloria trapped. She's fighting for her honor. You enter and take them on single-handed. Seven killers against one lone man. That's you. The greatest fight scene ever screened. Everything goes. No holds barred. You think you can do it?
Roll them.
Good old Ronnie. Places, everybody. This is picture. Wait! Quiet! Roll! Camera!
You gonna tell?
No! I'll never tell! Oh, if Ronald were only here!
Gloria!
Ronald!
Unhand that little gal. Blackie, from now on, you'll deal with me.
Cut! Hold it! Double, double, double.
Double!
Camera. Action!
Cut! Prince Deppard!
Ronnie, that was great. Finest thing I've ever seen.
Oh, it was not.
Good old Ronnie. All right, boys. There's a scene. All right, Ronnie. Now, this is a sensational scene. You've been left alone on the desert for 30 days without water. You're crazed with thirst. You're going mad. Suddenly, you come upon Blackie and his gang. He's your mortal enemy. But you've got to have water. You forget your pride. Your fans will think you're human. You've got to have water. You beg him for it. You think you can handle it?
Roll him.
What an act. All ready, Mr. Sturgeon.
All right. Camera!
Water. Water. Give me water.
What did you say?
Give it to me. Give it to me.
Cut! Hold it! Get the double.
Double!
Double!
Camera! Action! Pretty!
Terrific, Ronnie! An amazing performance. Such technique, such voice, such action, such savoir-faire.
All in knowing how. Been doing it for years.
Are you tired?
Me? No, I feel wonderful.
All right, boys, the party's... You're wet. How did that happen? All right, try them all.
Now, you know the next scene. You've escaped from the desert. You've come to see your sweetheart. She's not there, but Blackie and his gang are giving a party in her house. Are you up to it?
Roll them.
What an actor.
What an actor.
Places, everybody. Camera!
I'm losing my patience, O'Malley.
Yeah.
I'm losing my breath.
Nerve-wracking. I wish something had happened.
Looks like you're gonna get your wish.
The party's heading this way. Get out there and introduce the next act quick.
You can't go out there now. There's an act going on.
Yeah, then we'll get him when the act's over. Where's Murphy?
Danny!
Yeah. Oh. Hello, Mr. Richardson. I'm sorry we brought you down. I'm afraid we bit off more than we could chew.
How many have you got there?
What is it, about 1,400?
That's right.
Okay. Who will I make the check out to?
Danny.
Wonderful.
Which reminds me, the next act is cast daily.
That morning to see that everything was still all right. And when he opened up my mouth that morning, he said, my dear, there's not a tooth inside. I'll never smile again. My smiling days are through. I'm always making up my mind to stay away from men, but when I see someone wearing pants, I get the same old yen. I may wind up in another mess, but here I go again. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Oh, you can't blame a girl for trying.
finish your drink and let's get out of here.
No.
I said finish your drink and let's get out of here.
I said no.
Did I see you slap that young lady?
Yes, you did. And I'm not going home.
Let me see you do that again. Better go with him, lady. He's liable to kick your teeth in. Here's a check. How do I know that Duffy will accept this? How do I know it's any good?
Because I say it's good. And as my father's head cashier and main daughter, I accept the check and withdraw the charges. Your services are no longer requested.
Now, look here, Miss Duffy.
Oh, gee, Danny, thanks. You're the best fella guy ever had. I don't know how I can ever repay you.
I do. Archie, we'd like you to be best man at our wedding.
Wedding?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, sure, I'll be glad to.
Thanks, Arch. Come on, honey, we got a lot to talk about.
Yeah. Good luck to you.
Thank you, Archie.
Thanks. Gee, Archie, I'm sorry. I thought I was going to have you for a son-in-law. But if I ever have another daughter, I'll do everything I possibly can for you.
Thanks, BJ. Well, that's that. She was the only dame I could ever love.
Oh, there you are. What a show. Archie, you were wonderful.
Well, thank you, Miss Hutton. You don't mind me calling you Miss Hutton, do you?
Oh, of course not. Not after all we've been to each other. Well, see you around, pal.
Okay. It's a date.
Hey, Arch, come on. You got to introduce Bing Crosby's number.
Oh, okay.
Now we come to the big piece of resistance. A sketch with Dorothy L'Amour, Robert Benchley, and Bing Crosby. A man who ain't the father of his country, but you certainly got to give him credit for trying. See you later.
Myself in for this. See which is Crosby's heart. It's Crosby's house, all right. Good evening. I'm Mr. Benchley.
Oh, of course. Come right in, Mr. Benchley. It was awfully nice of you to come over this evening and look after the children.
Oh, anything for Bing. How are things here in Boys Town?
Quite interesting.
That's what I was afraid of.
Well, Mr. Crosby told me that if I ever needed any help, I could always count on Uncle Robert.
Well, he was so right. That's what Uncle Robert is for.
You're here to look after the children, remember?
Oh, am I? Well, I don't get along any too well with children, but I know Bings are different.
Well, that's one way of putting it. Anyway, I'll be back in a half hour. And if anything should happen, there's iodine and bandages in the closet.
It's fine. Good to know. Wonder if this is the kids' room.
Hey, that's the powder room, Bob.
Is it? Where's the kids' room?
In there.
Oh, thanks. Hey, did you speak to me?
Are you crazy? Who ever heard of a picture talking?
I guess you're right.
I said you struck out.
I'll go on. I only took a half a swing.
Half a swing, nothing. You're out.
Yeah, you're out.
I'm not going to give out the bat. You know the rules arguing about a decision. Now go sit in the corner.
Yeah. How come I always have to sit in the corner? I'm gonna ask Pop to change the rules.
Oh, God.
Don't push me around.
Come. What goes on here, anyway?
Oh, hello, Uncle Robert.
It's
seems to be the trouble, my good man.
We were playing 1-0 cat.
He struck out, wouldn't give up the bat.
The Pop says anybody who protests a decision has to go sit in the corner.
Well, well, why don't we settle the whole thing by having Uncle Robert tell you a story, huh?
What kind of a story, Uncle Robert?
Well, let's see, what about a Horatio Alger success story about the rise of Frank Sinatra?
Now, see here, Uncle Robert, that's one name we don't mention around here.
Well, I see your point. Well, then, what about the story of your dad's life?
Hot dog!
Okay. Now, this is the house in which Bing Crosby was born. What a thrill for the young mother as she tenderly pulled back the covers, saw her baby for the first time, and said... This is the little red schoolhouse where little Bing Crosby first went to school.
Who threw that?
I did, teacher.
Just for that, Harry Crosby, you're going to stay all alone with me after school for 1 hour.
Let's make it 2 hours, huh, teacher?
Why, Bing.
Traitor.
You see, it didn't take little Bing Crosby long to learn that teacher is the best experience. I mean, experience is the best teacher. Well, kids, little Bing Crosby started to grow up. And as with most growing children, he had an insatiable curiosity. But luckily, he always had his father to turn to.
Papa, who discovered America?
I'm afraid I couldn't exactly say, son.
Who was our first president?
Now, I don't know.
How many states in the Union, Papa?
Now, I'm not quite certain about that.
Papa, do I ask too many questions?
Not at all. You don't ask questions, how can you ever learn anything?
Didn't Pop ever go to high school?
Well, he certainly did. What a cut-up he was. I'll never forget the outfit he put on one Halloween. He's been dressing the same way ever since.
Didn't it scare away all the girls?
Au contraire, the girls were all crazy about him. But you can hardly blame them. Bing Crosby was known far and wide as the biggest spender in town. Why, when he took a girl out...
Usual. Make it for two.
Harry, are you sure you can afford it?
Nothing's too good for my girl.
Sure was cheap, wasn't he?
Yeah, and that was even before he met Bob Hope.
Well, it really didn't matter, though. Even in those days, when it came to women, he had the Crosby technique.
What does that mean?
Well, it means that when Bing Crosby sat on a girl's porch, he made love as only Bing Crosby can make love.
Harry.
Huh?
Do you think you could ever love me?
I don't know. How fast can you run a mile?
Pop went to college, too, didn't he?
That very year. In fact, that fall, they came to Gonzaga College, Bing Crosby, a scholar and a gentleman. Three fine fellows. Oh, you should have seen Bing during his college career. The first year,
I'm a freshman.
The second year,
I'm a sophomore.
Third year,
I'm a sophomore.
The fourth year,
I'm a sophomore.
The fifth year,
I am a freshman again.
Well, 3 years passed, but Bing didn't. So he hopped on a train and went to New York, determined to make good as a singer. New York was taken by storm. But Bing was determined. He worked hard, became one of the rhythm boys. Went to Chicago. Chicago was taken by storm. His rise was meteoric. Got his first break, a motion picture contract. Bing arrived in Hollywood. California was taken by storm. I said California was taken by storm. Well, you know California. See what I mean? From then on, his success was a legend. Song after song, picture after picture. Bing made Hollywood history. And then came Going My Way, And Bing's biggest success, Swinging on a Star.
Well, I'm sure happy you all come down to rehearsal. Now, if you just take your places, you'll see what we can throw together. You ready? From the young ladies, first, I would like to hear a nice, round, musical A. You ready? Hit it.
A!
Oh, we're cooked. How about the boys? Could you give me an athletic A? You feel up to it, old boy? Let's knock it. You ready?
A!
I think I detected a clinker in there somewhere. I better take a hack at it myself. Stand by.
Oh, would you like to swing on a star? How'd you like to carry moonbeams in a big fat jar? Or be better off than you are? Or would you rather be a ham?
A ham is an actor who believes he's adored. Just missed the Academy Award. His head gets bigger, and his smile does too.
That's the only kind of acting he can do.
You're so right. So if you don't mind the critics when they slam, you might grow up to be a ham.
Or would you like to swing on a star? Carry moonbeams home in a jar? And be better off than you are?
Or would you rather be a bear? A bear is an actress who comes on with a roar, and nobody else can have the floor. She looks like every night was Halloween.
I think Cass Daly is the one you mean.
So if you like catching people unaware, hey, you may grow up to be a bear.
Would you like to swing on a star? Carry moonbeams home in a jar? And be better off than you are?
Or would you rather be a cat? A cat is an actress with a voice that can purr, providing you are very nice to her. She can be nasty with the sweetest grin.
In other words, you mean Diana Lynn.
We must have a vitriolic cat. You might grow up to be a cat.
Would you care to join me in the chorus?
I will if I must.
I don't want you to knock yourself out. You think you can handle it?
Personally, I think I shall do a splendid job.
You are my man. I'll take a line. You take the next line.
Oh, would you like to swing on a star? Carry moonbeams home in a jar? And be better off than you are?
Or would you rather be a lamb? A lamb is an actress who has soft, charming ways. They want an all of Shakespeare's plays. Her voice is quiet, and she's so refined.
Are you kidding? You lost your mind?
You better shut your trap, grab your coat and cap, and then scram.
How would you rather be a lamb?
How would you like to swing upon a star? Carry moon, be home in a jar. How would you like this, my solo? How'd you like to swing?
I'd like to swing, I'd like to swing, I'd like to swing.
Stand by, I think it can be arranged. Or would you rather be L'Amour?
L'Amour is an actress and she gets reimbursed to let the director do his worst. She lives on islands and she sings a song.
Steady.
And gets pneumonia in an old sarong.
Well, if you don't care what the public must endure, you might grow up to be L'Amour.
Or would you dress in any old thing? Have a funny name such as Ba-ba-ba-bang? Have Sinatra sneer when you sing? Or would you rather be a snob?
A snob is an actor who will tell you his tops. He even brags about his flops. Now, when this boy plays golf, never counts his strokes. And that's not all, he tells those beat-up jokes. But if you're like a friend of mine called Bob, you might grow up to be a snob.
And all the monkeys are in the zoo. Every day you'll meet quite a few.
And what you do?
Step right up and say, howdy do, howdy do. Haven't we met at someone's bar?
Do 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 do
Duffy, Duffy, we got the dough. Oh, the CPA told you, huh? I can what? Well, thank you very much, Duffy, but I don't think I'll need the job. I'm thinking of retiring. Well, from the way a certain party has been reacting to me, don't be surprised if one of these days you are referring to me as Mr. Betty Hutton. I'll call you back. Magnetism.